Hey guys, what's going on? Today we're going to be doing an overview of the characters and team building. Now, I already did an equipment and soul boosting guide, so if you want to go check that out, it's probably going to be released in the same day as this video is going to be released because they kind of go hand in hand. I'm also trying to throw everything into one playlist for you so that way you know everything that's going on. Anyway, so this is the characters right now that we have. Let's go into the character list real quick. You can go over here in your character list. You could select the filter, right? I typically do extreme and sparking, leave my heroes gone. I was just doing hero because I needed a Yamcha. So let's do that, right? What's this? Not acquired. Interesting. Oh, those are those ones I don't have. So those are the only two characters I don't have that are extreme or higher. That's interesting. Okay, cool. I like how they do that. So I have my acquired ones, and there we go. So let's go and take a look at them, right? So each character has their own unique ability. So you go over here, you click on a character that you like, and you show the details. You see he's a sparking character by the name. Right in the middle is the element type. He's an intelligence type. He has a DBL, so Dragon Ball Legends 0117S. That's, the unique identifier that they have for the database. He's a ranged type character, as you see on the right-hand side. The stars are how far you have ascended them. All right, so I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So because I have 2,400 Vegetas, so essentially it's an SSR pull or a sparking pull gives you 600 of the characters. That means I've pulled him 4 times. I actually pulled him 3 times, and then I bought the pack that gave me 600 more. And the 10 was just for getting to level 25. So I need another 5 of them in order for him to get up, ascend it to the next level, which is ridiculous, actually. So I want him to get up to level 1,000 right now. I have him ascended to level 1,000. Yeah, the status screen over here, it has the stars. It tells you how many more until he's ascended to the next level, or until he's ascended to the next ability. Level 827 out of 1,000, I haven't maxed out that far. Friendship rank, he's almost maxed out to friendship, so that way I could teach what's-his-face his move. Shallot, his move Gallic Gun. He gives you the stats of his health, the boosts that you have given him, the base that he already has, how many equipment slots he has available, his key restoration speed, the episode that he's from. So he's from the Saiyan Saga Z. He's a male gender. He's R cards. He holds 2 Blast Arts cards. So you could take a look at these to see if you want to, like, if you need a special mission in the mission rewards, it's for like melee, do extra melee. Bring characters that have arts cards that are double melee, not double blast. You can look at the details over here. It just tells you about what those elements are. And then you can see his tags, Frieza, Force, and Saiyan. So when you see a character tag, there are certain abilities that will increase these tags, and you have to actually look to see if he's actually part of it. Like, Gohan is in a Saiyan, he's a hybrid Saiyan, so he won't get any Saiyan boosts, you know? You have the arts cards, it just tells you what kind of arts you have. The Ken Teach is what you could teach to Shallot. At least as of right now, it's only Shallot. When you click on these, this is what I was telling you before. It tells you how far you can go in order for the attack to actually hit. As you see over here, the blast, and I told you this on a video, I think it was either yesterday or whenever I released it. If you back up from a strike attack while they're sprinting towards you, if you're 2 blocks away from them, by the time they get to the first block, that's the one in the middle, if you back up before they get to the third block, you could actually avoid a strike. I believe that's a strike. I know it's happened with a special. So that's very awesome. Then you have Unlock Key Form Attack. It's a form of attack. It's a special green arts card. Each one is different for the different character. This one does 15% blast damage inflicted for 30 seconds. So that's because it's specifically for Vegeta. Vegeta does blast damage. There's 3 different abilities. You have the main ability, the Z ability, and unique ability. Main ability is just what when you click on it, when the timer goes and then they're glowing, you click on the actual character. Like Vegeta does a 50% blast and Piccolo will heal and stuff like that. This is specifically, it tells you what it does. 50% to blast damage inflicted for 20 seconds. Requirements, you need to wait at least 15 seconds before you could actually use it. Z ability is what is available as long as he's on the team of 6. It doesn't matter if he's actually active or not. That Z ability will become active, and that's what's going to come into the actual team building. So I have him ascend it up to 5 stars, so he has a Z ability level 3. So he gets 24% to tag Saiyan. Base blast attack to battle. So for blast attack goes up by 24% when the Saiyan tag is active or is there. So anyone who has that Saiyan tag will get that buff, and that's really awesome. Then you have the unique ability, which is plus 20% blast damage inflicted against tag Super Warriors. That's unique to Vegeta himself. It doesn't require any type of activation, but if he's going up against a Super Warrior like Tien or Yamcha or something like that have the Super Warrior tag, then he's going to do an additional 20% by default. Unique abilities can be useful. That's not really as useful right now because most of the time you're not really going up against anyone with Super Warrior, but he will do it. I think it's based off of the actual game. And I'll just to give you a quick comparison, we'll go ahead and take a look at the Goku over here. Now I have Goku at 3 stars. You see he's 700 out of 1400. We go ahead and click on this. He has two strikes because he's more oriented at strike damage than he is blast. He's kind of equal. You'll take a look over here. Blast damage is 2,200, and his strike damage is 22,000, and strike is 17,000. But he is he's part of the Saiyan, Super Saiyan, and Sun family. Normal attacks. Let's see the arts cards. He could teach the Super Kamehameha, and he has a special Super Dragon Fist. Which is awesome. Now, I don't know what's going on with these levels, by the way. I don't know if you can actually increase them or not. So that, I guess that's going to come out in the future. But we'll worry about that when the time comes. His abilities are, let's see, my turn. Draw the ultimate arts card, Super Dragon Fist, which is that which we saw down here, Super Dragon Fist, this guy over here. So then you have the Z ability too, 22% strike attack damage to Saiyans, anyone with the tag Saiyan. So he increases his strike attack with his Z ability is active. That's why he's better for suited for strikes. And then he gets Avenge Krillin unique ability. So he gets 35% additional blast damage when the allied character Krillin is defeated. So if you bring Krillin with you, and you have him fighting with you and you just let him die, Goku automatically gets a 35% attack buff to himself while he's active, and it looks like there's no time limit on that. So everyone's a little bit different. That's just so you know, that's how it's all built. So when you're going to do team building, right, we go over here, we go to characters, and now we already did the equipment. We're going to go to the edit. So I have over here, let's see, my Saiyan boost team minus Paikuhan, but all these guys, every single one of them, like Vegeta, right, his unique Z ability is 24% Saiyan based blast damage, right? Then we have Goku, which we already know, we talked about, he is 22% strike damage, right? Attack damage, strike attack damage. So he's giving all Saiyans, and they both have the Saiyan tag. Then you have this base form Goku over here. Show details. He has the Saiyan tag. Oh, wait, no, sorry, status. He has the Saiyan tag. His ability, Z ability to 20% to Saiyan-based strike attack, so another 20% to strike attack. So those two add up. Even if they're not actually being utilized, they're there. Now, this guy is a defensive type card. He's Saiyan and Sun family. When you go over to Z ability 1, Saiyan base strike defense plus 19%. So anyone with the Saiyan tag gets a 19% defense buff against strike attacks. It's melee attack. That's pretty awesome. Hence the defensive guy. And then you have Raditz, who does, let's see, his Z ability is Saiyan max base health 15%. So he's increasing the health. So just from that, you have the Goku who does the defense against strike attacks. You have the other two Gokus, the Super Saiyan Goku and the Sun Goku, the extreme version, that give strike damage increase, Vegeta, which is blast attack increase, Raditz, which is Saiyan health increase. Then we could actually remove PyCon, and you could add like Raditz up in here because he's another Saiyan, and he will get all the boosts. Because if you go over here and you look at it, he'll get the boost Frieza Force and Saiyan. Go look at his ability, and it's 15% damage inflicted to yellow characters, so he doesn't give anything to anyone else on the team, but he gets all of their buff. So just keep that in mind. Actually, what is his ability again? Is the ability 15% damage inflicted to yellow type? Yeah, so okay. So he does actually help them out, but you have to be going up against the yellow type. So if you're going up against the physical type, that's the one that the Super Saiyan Goku and the Nappa would be strong against. I kind of just threw PyCon in here just because I needed another sparking with a high level before I got any of these other guys up to 600. And that's pretty much it. I mean, that's how you're going to go ahead and build your teams. We're going to hit confirm on that. Let's go over here, and we have Party 3. I brought them because I'm actually trying to do something on the Nappa event. So let's go over here. We're going to hit edit, right? I have a Vegeta team right now, right? And Vegeta is, let's see, he is Saiyan, right? He has the Saiyan tag and the Frieza Force tag. So we also have Shallot. Shallot is a Saiyan. He has the Saiyan tags over here. That's all he has, a Saiyan tag. 10% to Saiyan max base health. So I could have thrown him on my Saiyan team for an increase in health again. We have Goku, which we already know is a Saiyan increase. Krillin I just threw in there, and then you have the two Raditzes, right? Krillin I just threw in there because, let's see over here. I'll show you right now. His ability, 15% blast defense for purple characters. So he gives Vegeta, this team is based off of Vegeta. Everything centers around Vegeta on this team. So that's where Vegeta gets his increase. He gets a 15% increase to defense because Krillin's on that team. So that's pretty much how you have it set up, and you just bring your strong characters with you. Again, we already did the soul increase and stuff like that. So that's pretty much it for how you're going to build your teams. It's pretty unique. It's pretty. The way I try to explain it is that way you could use it even if the game's like 2 months, 3 months, a year, 2 years in the future. Unless they incorporate other elements into it, this is probably going to be one of the best ways to do it. This one over here is something very similar that I did. It's not just Piccolo based, but it is green based. So this is green strike defense plus 22% green strike defense. Vegeta's in there just because he's a badass and he's one of my strongest characters. I need someone to actually kill because Piccolo doesn't kill that much. Yamcha's ability is green base strike attack plus 18%. Then you have Frieza, and as you see, none of these guys actually really match up. They're all green-based. Green base, max health, plus 10%. So you could do stuff like that. You could actually just, you could honestly just bring crappy cards just for their Z abilities, you know? So like Chiaotzu, you all know I hate Chiaotzu. 18% blast defense during battle for green characters. It's actually very, very useful. And Zarbon, the last one over here, who is 15% green blast attack, 15% increase. That's awesome. So you have a whole bunch of stuff that you could do here. It doesn't need to be specific to Saiyans. It could be specific to attribute type, or however the heck it's built at the time of that you're playing. But that's pretty much it. I'm pretty sure I went over everything over here. We went the character list. We went over equipment and stuff on the last one. So just keep that in mind when you're building your teams. Make sure you build them to that way they boost each other. So that way you have my Saiyan team over here. I'll go ahead just for to explain or to show you a little bit more. Filter. And then we're going to go here, and there we go. Now, where is my Shallot? Shallot, come here. You are a hero. And now he's part of that team. Now he's part of the Saiyan boost. And now I have the team all set up. Now what I want to do is I want to go change the equipment on this team. Now, none of these guys have equipment set up, so I can go on here. I could go find equipment that would suit Shallot, and I could throw it on. I think I have some of them ascended all the way at the bottom over here. So, like, let's just give him this guy over here. I don't even know what the heck Raditz is. Strike defense, strike attack, super warrior, special attack. So, actually, having this on him, he's not a super warrior. I'm pretty sure it's just for Saiyan. Yeah, here we go. So, we're going to give him the Goku. Hit confirm. And now he's set up. Now, I have Vegeta set up, too. So, I'm going to go throw Vegeta on here, and we're going to go take a look. And then we have the same thing with with the Raditz over here. What is his last one? I don't have him ascended. That's why. So, we go over here, and we'll just throw that on, and he is... Is he increased Super Warrior Special Attack plus 30%? Yeah, so we don't really do anything with that. And you can just go through here, and you set up your characters based off of that. You could also do builds for, like, defense, attack, specific to blast attack, stuff like that. That's getting very unique. We don't have enough characters in-game as of right now. But now they have a little bit additional boost on top of it. Their levels are going to go up a little bit higher. You're going to be able to survive a little bit longer, and you could definitely set it up. But yeah, guys, that's it. Let me know if you have any questions. Let me know if I left anything out. Maybe I should do a follow-up video. Maybe I will if you guys think that there's some things that need to be added. If not, just let me know if that was helpful and what else you guys would like to see. But anyway, guys, I'll catch you later. I'll see you down in the comments below. Peace.